Mayhem is the only way to describe the goings-on at the Tarleton Hotel this weekend. With the hotel running into financial problems, I have decided that something drastic must be done. As a music lover, I decided to promote a festival of music with a difference. I realised with the winter approaching, every village hall is busy with young amateur performers rehearsing for their annual show, staging anything from the great musical traditions of Broadway and Drury Lane. I've decided to give them a chance to show off their pieces to a wider audience by competing in a festival atmosphere. I'll boost business by allowing them to rehearse at the hotel. This, however, leads to several problems, as I overlook the fact that a murder weekend and a political convention have also been scheduled for that weekend. What a solid dance.
Thank you. Yes, why? Not telling the
truth. Well, actually, the motor group were scheduled to be in the lounge before.
Well, why not? When they come in, you divert them to the conservatory. The politicians at best have the lounge. There's enough hot air in the conservatory as it is. Annette, remember, they must be out and the furniture cleared by four. We've got the Balhulish belters coming to rehearse South Pacific at five.
My dad seems to have a soft spot for politicians.
Was he really?
Yes, the people on the right.
I've suffered lots of opportunities in inner cities. I've been to garden beds, factories, and hospitals. I have this baby been diagnosed to have, but I never expected to find myself chewing a hotel with a kind of staged up action at this limelight.
No comment.
I thought some of the parties specialised in that. What about the scout detectives? I know you're kind of specialising in law and order, but this is ridiculous.
I thought I was here for a cross-party convention. I'm very cross indeed. I came for peace and quiet. I thought we could commune with nature. I thought we could relate to each other. You know, in harmony.
That's a major festival of beer. You should get plenty of harmony.
When we eat, I do so hope everything are grand to you. Perhaps a bit of chef to chef. I'm not too sure what the preliminary meeting is for.
It's to establish a solution to the initial door dialogue. The point of the chairperson is quite integrity. The capability of putting the correct atmosphere to enable an effective decision to be made.
Quite so. Names is bad.
Well, I can truthfully say, at this moment in time, there's a fear of contradiction. The bottom line is, we initiate the dialogue. At the end of the day, we won't have meaningful discussion.
Yes, but who will be chairperson?
Oh, I think we can reach an amicable decision for a glass of gin and tonic. Anyone care to join me in the cocktail bar?
Thank you. much. The time's gone on. Things have improved a lot.
Yes, I'm not so lonely now that I've made some new friends.
Look, guys, I think the lighthouse is trying to tell us something.
Thank you.
songs, and me unable to work in my own kitchen, these waitresses were practicing their dance steps on the kitchen tiles.
I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love with all wonderful girls.
See what I mean?
I give up. When he asked Donna to create the same song, this is what he produces. And where's Miss Kaplan? I won't tell that they noticed.
Miss Packner, I get it all mixed up. Different parties wanting different foods at different times. He's always in a bad mood and picking on me.
Well, someone has pinched my best knife. How is a creative artist like me supposed to work with my favourite knife? A sculptor needs his mallet, an artist needs his brush, a musician...
Calm down, Andy. It's not easy for me either with all these interruptions.
We promised some scraps in your kitchen.
Scraps? In my kitchen? Bah! I don't understand, Holmes. What do you want with scraps?
Always ready for emergencies, in case you meet the head of the basket box.
When we soon save all we see Brussels sprout on the menu, may I come and check the condition of the vegetable? Do you know that it must not be overcooked?
This is too much.
Oh, what is he here? I thought I heard the chef's voice.
He is retreating to the kitchen. He pulled up the drawbridge too.
Oh, I just wanted to tell him exactly what's in my cucumber sandwiches and my afternoon tea. I do think it is so important to get cucumbers like quite thinly up, don't you? I'll just go and speak to him, and the teapot must be warmed to just precise. Right, take some of
the food. Don't think that's a good idea.
Ah, Mrs. Tiger.
Is the steam heading good up here?
I'm not sure. I'm not to bother this myself.
Oh, in that case, I'll have 20 evil king's house.
I said to bother this, not to back this.
Right, that's it. I'm handing my notice. Brussels sprouts. Can't take any more. How can I cut cucumber thinly without my favourite knife?
Oh, please, not this weekend. I'll pay you double your wages. Triple your wages.
I'm as corny as Kansas in August, high as a flag on the 4th of July. If you'll excuse an expression, I'm fine and welcome now on the moon.
And so, the cross-party convention begins at last. Iona Garden is still crossed by the crowds. Riddell's in the chair. No, Riddell's in the chair. He thought you were purple, if you did have to stand. Kinlochleven was going to take the chair, but Scott A. Beard told her that Tiger would be sure to track her down. And as for Natalia gets close, tell that to the miners and see what you get.
Comrades! Brothers! Sisters! Ladies! Gentlemen! And conservatives! I believe the things to mention are across. Cross party, party conventional. What's it matter? Order!
Oh, thank you. I'll have a green tea with a slice of lemon, please.
Conventional purpose. No, purpose to conventional. It's to change Scotland's image as a tourist destination.
Here, Ruby, look at Scottish Labouring Bees. It's a big to change a light bulb.
I don't know, Miss Blair. How many Scottish Labouring Bees does it take to change a light bulb?
Scottish Labouring Bees don't change anything.
Order!
Now then, you're mad. I'm still waiting for my first one.
Do you
The natural resources of the North Sea are red, white, and blue.
Why's that, man? How not to kill? Please, you've never put one of your vinegar in your fish and chips.
That's tart and oil.
Order!
It's all right, Wendelin. Mrs. Garn came to the bar.
I didn't know she was a lawyer.
I think the official adjourned this meeting for just now. We're getting nowhere, which is no surprise considering the last 14 years. But anyway, we've all got a lot of work to do with presentations. Anyone fancy a game of poker?
Hey, there, Mother. You're lucky Democrat. Take the change of light bulb.
I don't know. Every liberal Democrat doesn't take the change of light bulb.
Liberal Democrats are too good to change the party name to change anything.
Thank you.
tell the lady to speak of a duchess.
Yes. 10 pounds, you can't. Now, come here, girl.
I'm a good girl, I am.
Her name. Yes, she is, Vicky. Come on. Come with me and I can do you. What's he wanted? Chocolate. Yes, lots and lots of chocolate.
And make me speak like a duchess.
And turn you into a duchess, my dear.
Gavin! Yeah. Oh, hi, Nancy.
Hi.
Has anyone seen Dylan? No, Nancy, I haven't. See me and Callum right in the
cave. I think he's been avoiding me for 3 hours already. Give him a popcorn.
Thank you.
deaf girl.
You have no argument.
So what are we going to do
then? Well, we want to do.
Let's go somewhere.
Thank you.
too. Such a lovely window with a marvelous panoramic view. So peaceful and quiet.
That's precisely the problem, my dear. It's too peaceful and quiet. We mustn't forget that we're here to encapsulate the Scottish identity, to launch a logical logo, to tempt the tourists.
To try
talking to tartan telephones.
That's it, Daddy.
colours. First, we must establish the cause of death. Is it natural causes? I doubt it.
Is it any single weapon?
Let us consider the method. Who might have a weapon in this area? A gamekeeper, perhaps? When they heard you shot.
Aha! This looks suspiciously like murder, or the suicide.
Poor young man! I've seen him before! He seemed frightened, you know, as if he had something on his mind.
You mean apart from a knife?
I think it is murder. Observe, to commit the suicide, he would try to run around behind himself to stab himself in the side of the head.
True, your little face cells are working well under the point of mental pressure. Then, I consider something much more conclusive than that.
Well, what is it? Tell us.
Well, we did book for a murder weekend.
What is it they say in these circumstances? Nobody leaves the hotel.
Now you've got a chance to finish the
intend to hear your views.
I do so believe blue tartans are awfully pretty. I especially like the Kennedy or Fletcher. Both built them in this place. But let's go for the major one. It couldn't possibly offend anybody.
Offend anybody? Blue, in my constituency. Have you forgotten? I'd lose all my votes. No blue in Parkhead.
At least I had an idea. What did anyone else come up with? We're always being accused of being wishy-washy. But this tartan makes a strong statement. And I approve of the colour.
Pollution! Pollution of the worst kind! Visual pollution!
Typical, all show and no substance. I'd like something really Scottish. How interesting. I've always liked animals. But isn't it the tiniest bit aggressive? I'm surprised that you chose that one. An SMP. I didn't think you'd want boils in dresses all the time. Didn't you know that's the flag flown when the Queen visits Scotland?
Oh, that's out there. Anyway, we're here to discuss the tartan image, not bias. Let's get back to basics.
Great, you've made my day.
I'll just the one. We'll suit everybody. Alright, Campbell. And it'll be accepted throughout Scotland, because everybody knows Karl Marx's mother was a Campbell.
What? A Campbell? A little Big Mac? A chicken and nuggets? Anyway, a Campbell? In this part of the country?
Forget it.
Quite right. We must avoid local controversy. Remember what happened with the zebra crossing? The fuss over whether black or white stripes came first. The accountants make sure there was an equal number.
Oh yes, I forgot about that. You had to run the stripes across the road instead of parallel, so that neither colour could feed the fish and walk the cars. I thought they could put some red and yellow ones as well.
That's right. However, this is rather nice and will blend in nicely.
Typical, a phone box that no one can find.
I'm surprised at you choosing that one. Didn't you know that's a hunting tartan?
Oh goodness me, I shall have to think again.
I thought again. I went and painted with the salt iron. Easily seen and unmistakably Scottish.
Now I do like that. Very elegant. What are that helicopters landing all over the place?
Back to the drawing board, I'm afraid.
Mr. Eel. Rumour has it that you've got absolutely nowhere at all this morning. Would you like to come in?
Well, I'm glad you asked for that. And considering the circumstances, I'd say we've made good progress.
Yes!
And we'll be issuing a statement tomorrow.
Yes!
Thank you.
Just mountain brothers they had done Joseph a good turn. The story is well known how after some hardship in Egypt, Joseph prospered because of his ability to understand the meaning of dreams.
Pharaoh heard about him and used him to interpret the dreams of the fat and lean cattle.
Joseph predicted the years of plenty followed by a famine and suggested stockpiling and saved Egypt from starvation. Pharaoh was so impressed that he raised Joseph to high office with great wealth and powers.
Back in Cana, at first Jacob believed he never had it so good. It was a land flowing of milk and honey and every other kind of food.
But since they lost Joseph, they've gone to the other extreme. No one goes to dinner now.
We can only eat them anyhow. We also find we're missing Joseph's dreams.
Life is slowly ebbing from us. Hope is almost gone.
It's getting hard to see us from sideways on.
We'll starve if we stay here.
And in Egypt, there's food going spare.
And in Canaan, it looked rough. Jacob's family were finding it tough.
The famine got them unprepared. They are thin, they are ill, they are getting scared.
It's enough to make anyone weep. They are down to their very last sheep.
So they finally decided to go off to Egypt to visit their brother Joseph.
When they arrived in Egypt, they did not recognize Joseph. All they saw was a powerful prince, but he recognized them. They humbly begged him for food, which he gave him, and he decided to check if they changed their jealous evil ways and to set a trap.
He hid a cup in young Benjamin's sack.
As the brothers left,
stop!
Joseph accused them of theft and demanded a search.
When the cup was found, Joseph pretended to be angry.
How could you stoop so low? I give you food, and in return you dare to steal my favourite cup.
I've never seen it before. I've been framed. I would never steal anything, especially from you, almighty prince.
How can I believe you? You must have taken it.
Oh no! Not Benjamin!
Thank you.
waiter, there's no chicken in this pie.
You don't get dog in the dog biscuit, do you?
What my dad want for?
Coffee.
Yeah, me too.
So that's two coffees for table two.
Isn't this a nice hotel? Pity about the service.
Yes.
I haven't had my dad on fork yet.
Just terrible.
This coffee tastes like mud.
I'm not surprised, sir. It is brown like this. Is this English or late?
Don't ask me, I'm only English.
We'll pay for our bill now. Yeah. I want a fork, not two knives.
Sir, this looks bad.
So was the meal.
Yes, let's get rid of this place.
Thank you.
suggest fun. I'm only doing this to mingle in the crowd, undercover stuff to catch the murderer.
Now you see the sacrifice I made for my profession. Still, a party must be made to keep you guys in the house.
Miss Crackle, is it your questions already? No quite enough.
Talk about sacrifice. I know that's where it blew in front of you-know-who.
Will I tell her?
Time to break the habits of a lifetime due to winter time.
Oh, anyway.
I can't believe that even you would wear a red tie with a pink shirt. I know you're a gentleman's heart. Let's see, you look like one. You're a fine one to talk about image. You certainly changed yours. Oh no, not at all. This is the real me. Back to basics. I used to be a bright young thing, a leading light in the Kinlochleven young Tony.
Did you hold your hand on that? To the top of the
water.
Miss
Blackburn is ready for you now.
These are for you. I would not wear feathers. Some poor old bird must be shivering in the cold. This is a dodo.
Person falls in love and out again over the phone. Thank you. like to thank our community for coming out over the last few nights and supporting this show so magnificently. To be honest, I think they deserve it. There's a huge number of people involved with a show such as this, and to be honest, we simply couldn't name all of them tonight. There's some people who we will name in passing, others perhaps who will be up here and be thoroughly embarrassed in a few minutes. But if you just go through some of the very important people who helped support this particular show. Firstly, there's the people who work in front of the house. My team of bouncers who were standing at the front door intimidating everybody as they came in, selling programmes, making sure nobody escaped. There's the people working in the tuck shop at the intervals, doing all these essential little tasks. Nothing that I think shows this can't function without. There's quite a lot of people also involved in the organisation that you don't see. Mrs. Gies in the art department, responsible for much of the scenery. Mrs. Leith, whose voice you may have heard after coming in from the corners on the occasion if somebody was unfortunate enough to get that line. These people play a very, very important part in running the show, and I'd like to show their appreciation. Responsible for most of the music,
absolutely first rate. The person in charge of music, Peter Duggan.
You know you love me. princess alive.
Talking about routines, is everyone ready?
Thank you.
You still using You check the US.
You're not fidgeting that, are you?
Thank you.
No way!